was our father when she got sick.
We have to have faith.
I have no faith. Joe, it's God. I've chosen you for a special mission.
Very funny. Whoever hacked my computer, no need to confess, please. Just unhack it.
He is an actor, director, producer, and activist. And you've seen him bring so many characters to life. The Pachuco in Zoot Suit, William Adama in Battlestar Galactica, Jaime Escalante in Stand and Deliver, Lieutenant Castillo in Miami Vice, for which he won an Emmy for Best Supporting Actor. Today we speak to Edward James Olmos about a role that is like no other that he's ever played. He plays Joe Amable-Amo, a bank executive and former amateur golfer in the film Walking with Herb. We are so happy to have Edward James Olmos with us today. So, Edward, I loved you in Walking with Herb. It's a role that I've never seen you play before. How did you decide that you wanted to do this film?
You know, this film was given to me by Mark Medoff, who's the Academy Award nominated writer. Who won the Tony for Children of a Lesser God. He's a brilliant writer. And he wrote this piece and he said, I wrote this for you.
Tell me about how the casting came to be. So you're on first and then
George was second. They asked George to come on, yeah. And George was very excited and said yes. And I was very grateful that he decided to come on board. He had called me and said, hey man, are you gonna do this movie? I said, you know, I got to tell you, it's a real different kind of a film, but I'd love to do it with you if we could get it together. And he says, yeah, I'll do it, man. Are you kidding? I said, okay, then let's go for it. And that's how it went. And it is the best chemistry I've had on screen since Stand and Deliver.
And I got to tell you, I have never seen you smile so much in any other role that you've played. And it was so wonderful, and you guys really belong together as a team.
Well, he thought when he got the script that he was going to play Joe, and I was going to be the caddy and teacher of the golf because he's a real golfer, right? Then he found out that he was going to play Herb, and I was going to play Joe, and he said, holy mackerel.
You guys have known each other for forever, but... Yeah. There was this ease that I could see this going into another film because it with you guys working together in those kinds of roles, because it was so easy, it was so heartfelt, and the dynamic was really, really great. So tell everyone why he is such a special guy that comes into your life.
So in this time of complete lack of any more feeling of faith or in hope, or it's shattered, my life is shattered. And, in rides Herb.
All of these lines are being crossed over the
atmosphere. Herb. Joe, Amable-Amo.
Joe, I get you to trust and believe. And your part is to turn all of that self-doubt into faith.
What's the mission?
Yes.
He comes in as the messenger from God.
It was just wonderful to see you guys. And also the fact that he is teaching you to golf.
The Artesia Country Club, bright and early.
Coming in to finish the sign-up, Dave.
You haven't played in years.
35, to be exact.
Now, JoJo, hit me a nice fade. Sponge cake.
I got to tell you, let me just say this. George is a brilliant golfer. He's been playing golf since 1981. And, you know, his handicap's like a 4, 3, 4, 5. You know, at any given time, he can hit par at boom. And on any course in the world. And he's a real strong golfer. He's a pro in many ways. But I'll tell you right now, he's a better actor than he is a golfer after this movie.
It was a beautiful, beautiful film to watch. It takes you on a little journey. And it is a feel-good movie. It makes you kind of reflect on how to handle everything. And it was a blast seeing George Lopez as, would you say he's God? Because I got that.
Each person to themselves, but at the end, I mean, towards one moment in the thing that made me cry, because I didn't know he was going to do that, and you'll see it in the movie, where he actually comes to me, and we're talking there on the golf course, and right before one of the most crucial moments of the game, and of the movie, and You tell me what you think.
Well, that's the part that I'm talking about.
I know.
It literally comes in your face and you're saying, well, where is he? And, you know, that's what I'm talking about. I don't want to give it away because it's a really crucial point in the movie. But I totally had a big smile when I watched Edward James Olmos and George Lopez playing a golf pro, and George Lopez, someone very, very close, or God himself. So it was amazing. It was amazing.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
So we will watch. We will make sure that we let everyone know what a beautiful film it is. And thank you so much. I had a wonderful time seeing you, as I've never seen you before. Big smiles, well, towards the end of the movie, the middle of the movie. And you're just, I mean, you should do more of those roles. Everyone out there, please write some roles for Eddie, that, because he was wonderful. Don't go watch Walking with Herb.
It's going to open in April 30th. May 1st, 2nd, and 3rd, and the Phantom concept of screenings throughout the entire country. So it'll be playing everywhere on 4 days. And if it really takes off, then we'll be able to move into the next understanding. And but I got to tell you right now, it is an amazing journey that it's needed today. If anything, we need more hope today than we've ever needed it in our existence as human beings.
Thank you so much, Edward.
You're welcome.
Always
You're
a welcome. Pleasure to speak with you.
Bless your heart. Thank you.
Bye-bye. Thank you so much for joining us. I just thoroughly enjoyed talking with Edward James Olmos. We hope that you will come back and visit us for other interviews. Until next time.
I've never seen two sober people in a golf course have this much fun.